In this segment, we'll talk about some special matrices called diagonal and identity matrices. And again, these are important matrices to understand since you want to learn the numerical methods of solving simultaneous linear equations. So let's go and look at these special matrices. What is a diagonal matrix and what's an identity matrix? Now, if you look at a diagonal matrix, in the diagonal matrix, all your off-diagonal elements are zero. So n by n matrix A is a diagonal matrix if all off-diagonal. So that means that all the elements which are not on the not on the diagonal, all off-diagonal elements are zero. What does that mean? That basically means that Aij, that the values of the A's of ij is equal to zero if I is not equal to j. So because all the off-diagonal elements will have the row number and column number to be different from each other, and the value of the elements of A has to be zero for those. Doesn't what makes a diagonal matrix is not what is on the diagonal. What makes a diagonal square matrix diagonal is what is not on the diagonal, and you want all the off-diagonal elements to be zero. An example of that is, let's suppose we take a 4x4 matrix here. So we have 2, 3, 5, minus 7 on the diagonal, and everything else has to be zero. Everything else has to be zero. So you're looking at all the off-diagonal elements are zero. So any of the elements which you are looking for, so you have this elements below the diagonal are zero, elements above the diagonal are zero. It doesn't matter what's on the diagonal. I could have a zero, all of one of or all of these to be zero, and it'll still be a diagonal matrix. So instead of three, I had a zero, it's still a diagonal matrix, because what makes a particular matrix to be diagonal is what's not on the what's on the off diagonal elements. All the off diagonal elements have to be zero. So if you look at any of these elements which are off the diagonal, the row number is not same as the column number. So for example, this one here is third row, first column. This one is third row, second column. This one is third row, third column, so I don't even look at it. I only look at the elements where the row number is not same as the column number, which is same as saying that I'm looking at elements which are not on the diagonal, and they all have to be zero. And only then can I call that matrix to be diagonal. Now, let's go and look at the identity matrix, which is a very important matrix to be to understand so far as solving equations are concerned and finding inverses of matrices. So we'll do that later. So what's the identity matrix? N by N matrix is an identity matrix. An identity matrix is actually a special case of a diagonal matrix. And so if you have an identity matrix, N by N matrix, an identity matrix, if all the off diagonals, since it's a special case of a diagonal matrix, all the off-diagonal elements are zero. But there's a restriction on the diagonal elements, and all diagonal elements are one. So you cannot have anything on the diagonal elements other than one. No zeros, no minus ones, minus twos, or anything like that. All the diagonal elements have to be one, the number one. That's what we call as identity matrix. So a typical example of identity matrix, let's suppose we take a 4x4 matrix, will be that all the diagonal elements have to be one. All the off-diagonal elements have to be zero. All the off-diagonal elements have to be zero. So you're seeing that all the off-diagonal elements which are these are below the diagonal, these are above the diagonal, they're all zero, and whatever you have on the diagonal is a number one, nothing else. And that's called an identity matrix. And that's the end of this segment.